بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Conservation of forages for commercial livestock production operations. So this topic basically cover silage and hay making processes which are mostly used for the conservation of forages in our country. So before going to this topic, just a little quotation. What is the point of being alive if you don't at least try to do something remarkable? By John Green. So this is a very important point. If we are living in this world, we have to perform our role. We should be proactive rather than be reactive, and we should play our role for the benefit of mankind. So now come to the topic. Why we should go for forest conservation? So in Pakistan, we have a problem of seasonal shortages of green fodders during different periods of the year. So there are two main periods, May, June, that's a hot summer month, December and February, that's a severe cold weather. During these months of the year, the fodder is not available in sufficient quantity. So, but at the same time, we have a solution for this lean period. We have a surplus fodder during the month of July, September, and then in March and April. So we can go for conservation of forage during this month because this surplus fodder cannot be used for animal feeding or can be sold at a low price. So if we go for preservation, so we can use it during fodder shortage period, and even we can sell it at a high price when the fodder is not available. So what is silage? Silage is basically a fermented forage plant. So we do ensiling of the plant, and due to fermentation, it is simply just like a pickled green fodder. You can compare it with making a pickle process. So this process is similar to that of preserving fruit or vegetables in the form of pickle. So it is a fermented forage plant. So it is a very old method and being used for the preservation of food and feed item. Columbus found that American Indians, they were using pits or trenches for the storage of grain. Likewise, in 1865, and this Frenchman, Auguste, that preserved forage in a silo, and he was awarded with an honor, that's the Cross of Legion of Honor from the French government. So you can say how this process is important for feeding the animals during the period of shortage. So before going into detail of silage making, first we will discuss the advantages of this silage. So there are a lot of advantages when we compare it with the other preservation technique. So we can do or we can make silage during the weather which is not suitable for hay making, like when there is a rain or when there is less sunshine, we can preserve the fodder. So this is the most economical form in which we can preserve the whole stock of the corn or sorghum. Otherwise, that should be given to the animal, and that have a low or poor nutritional quality as compared to the grain or leafy portion of the plant. So if that part is inside with the other part of the plant, so that will result in a better nutritive value. So you can say we can improve even the quality of the stuff which is poor in nutritive value or nutrients. So to store and enable extended use of potentially unstable material, when we compare it with the hay, so that can be helpful for preserving those unstable stuff for a long time. So just keep in mind, if we have a mango and we cannot keep it for a long time, if we make a pickle of that mango, that can be used for the whole year. Next advantage is, as such, the succulents or the moisture content, they are high, and that is liked by the animal. Next is preservation of high proportion of nutrients of plant. So that can be that can be accomplished by hay making, but hay making process result in a loss of nutrient because there is a shedding of the leaves in case of hay making, and there due to sunshine there is a loss of nutrient due to the bleaching. So in silage grass, it can preserve up to 85% or more of the feed value of the crop, whereas in case of hay making, that only preserve 80% when that's being done under favorable or a good environment condition. But under the poor condition, only 50 to 60% of the nutritive value of plant can be preserved in case of hay making. Next point is more forages can be preserved from fewer acres. I mean, we can cut at an appropriate stage and then we can go for preservation. And that area can be easily utilized or the crop can be given a time so that it can regrow, or you can go for the next crop. So that will result in more preservation of the fodder from the less area. So that would definitely increase the carrying capacity of that area. Like here is the example, corn as a silage crop, it yields more total digestible nutrient per acre than most other forages. And it has 30 to 50% higher feeding value as silage than when fed as a grain and stored. Next point, it requires less storage space per pound of dry material than dry hay. When we compare it with the dry hay, so it requires less space on per pound of dry material basis. So even if we go for making bales or chopping of the hay, that require more space because there is dryness in nature. Here is the example, a cubic feet of silage contain about 3 times more dry weight of feed than cubic feet of long hay stored. So the next point, it also eliminates the danger of loss by fire. If we are making hay and keeping it in the store, so chances of fire hazards are very high. Even if we preserve the hay under the recommended moisture contents, so the chances of fire are there. Most satisfactory and economical way of preserving product as well as byproduct feeds, you can see. So it makes it possible to remove forage crop from the land earlier than would otherwise be possible. Just given a bit earlier, if we can harvest an appropriate time and we can preserve it in the form of forage, but if we go for hay making, then we have to keep that plant in the field, or if we are using the land area for grazing purpose as a pasture, or giving fodder after harvesting, so the plant remain in the area. We cannot go for re-sowing or reutilization of that area. Next point is, it is the best method of controlling pest. Here is an example of European corn borer. Because the stalk is removed, so when there is no stalk, the European corn borer cannot be there. Next point is preserve nutrient, mostly protein, vitamins, carotene, and some unknown factors. They are being preserved during this process. But in case of hay making, drying the forages, lot of loss of nutrients. Next point is, it's basically the fodder preservation with almost 60, more than 65% of its moisture content. So it makes a material succulent. So it is a palatable feed and have slightly laxative effect in nature. So there's a less feed wastage because entire plant is being inside and then it is being consumed by the animal, which is an important consideration, particularly when we have a coarse stuff or when we have a fodder that have a more stemmy part rather than more leaves. Next advantage is, it may be completely mechanized as a feeding system, saving labor and time. Yes, in developed countries, they do their they have their mechanized system, and they do they are doing some like mechanized system having picking up the silage from the bunkers and going through the feed lines and into the feed mill. So complete mechanized system can be established, so that will help to save the labor and time. And it also offer lot of other advantages when we compare it with the pasture. No fencing is required, approximate 1/3 more forage from the same area. Harvesting is done at an optimum maturity, so we can get maximum nutritive value of the plant. There is a more uniform quality because the fodder is cut at the same time, and the chances of bloat are very little or no. Then close observation of animal that are confined to a lot, because if animal they are on the pasture, we cannot safeguard or we cannot watch each and every animal. But if the animals they are on a lot, on a confined to a lot, so they can be easily monitored. So there is less damage to the growing plants, growing sward, lessen loss of topsoil, because when animals they are moving in the grazing area, so due to their feet or hoof, so they have a treading action, and that result in loss of topsoil. So that ultimately reduces the fertility of the area in some cases. Though there is an added advantage of animal dung to be there that act as a green manure, but chances of this topsoil loss are there. So in addition to the benefits of silage making or Baker bean fodder, there are some disadvantages. So we should keep in mind those disadvantages. Okay. Now, for best result, there must be a structure where we can store this fodder, or where we can make this silage. So silage is a structure which is required, and definitely the initial cost for making silo is high. Though some alternates are there, but at least we have to go for some structures. So, and then we have to some operating equipment for that structure. Then it contains considerably less vitamin D than sun cured hay. Yes, definitely when we go for drying the plant due to the sun, the vitamin D might be more in that case. That would be less in case of silage. Next point, 2 to 3 times as much quantity of forage to be handled as when the same forage is dried due to high water content. Because we are going for handling the stuff with more than 65% of moisture, so definitely more labor will be required, more vehicle will be required. So handling cost is more at the time of silage making at the time of feeding. Extra cost when preservatives are required. When we have a plant which cannot be inside, or due to less amount of soluble sugars in the plant, or if we are cutting the plant at later stages, particularly when we go for harvesting the crop for grain making. So at that time, the plant they are less nutritive. They have a less nutritive value because their soluble sugars they have been consumed while making the grain. So that's why we need some preservatives to improve the ensiling properties, to improve the fermentation process, or to increase the shelf life of the silage, or to facilitate the ensiling process. So there are different preservatives that are required. Last point is, it lessen the amount of organic material returned to the soil, which is needed in some soil types. Definitely when we cut the plant and we do not going to leave the plant there, so that all plant is being used for silage making. So little or no organic material is being left in the soil. So return to the soil in that case is low, and definitely we need more fertilization for the next crop for its proper growth. So this is about advantages and disadvantages of silage making. So next come the solid making factors that should be keep in mind while considering a solid making operation. So these are the important factors which we must keep in mind while deciding about solid making program. We have a seasonal availability of fodder. Yes, this is an issue. Requirement for feed supplement, it might be required or not. Then type of farm system, either we have a mechanized farm system that can facilitate utilization of silage, or if we have a manual system, then it's okay. Then what about the climate? If and the climate suitable for hay making, then better to go for hay making rather than going for silage making. So they all are the deciding factors while planning for silage making. Then question is there a need for silage making, or we have some alternatives? If we have some alternatives, then better to go for growing the fodder crops. Suppose a farmer that have a sufficient area, so that can go for growing a fodder crop rather than doing this extra exercise. But again, we have the benefit. We have already discussed that surplus area can be used for silage making, and that can increase the revenue generation. So is there a need for silage making? Yes, if there is a need, so then is there sufficient good quality forage? Because when we have to plan this preservation, so we have to consider our resources, and particularly the availability of the good quality forage at that time. So the fodder should be in excess amount. That is a positive point. If there are crop residues that cannot be fed as such, so they can be inside with the fodder crop, that will improve the crop residue nutritive value. And certainly, if some byproducts are available, so that can also be inside. So excess forages, crop residues, and byproducts, they can be inside to improve. To have a better silage quality. But again, technically we have to look for how much quantity of crop residue or byproduct can be feasible to add in terms of its economic worth. The more important about the moisture content. If by adding crop residue the moisture content decreases in the overall silage, so that will deteriorate, or that will reduce the quality of the forage. Then can the required conditions be met, like harvesting at a young stage of growth, contain enough sugar or soluble sugars for fermentation, or it can be easily compactable? So these are the conditions which we must keep in mind at the time of silage making. Though if we are meeting these conditions, then definitely we will have a good quality silage. Otherwise, if we are cutting a forage at a later time or a very early time, so that will result in a poor quality silage. Because due to less amount of fermentable sugars, definitely we will have an issue. Then easily compactable mean that the structure which we have made that is easily compactable, or we can easily press that stuff. Then molasses or another source of sugar can be added. Yes, if fermentable sugars are not present in sufficient amount, then we can add molasses or some other sources of soluble sugars. So poorly made silage can cause health problems in animal. So this is a very good flow diagram that is adopted from an article. So it could help us to decide our plan making for the silage.